Hello folks, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to provision a new document library in SharePoint site using Power Automate. So stay tuned and let's go to the demo after this short intro. I am inside a Microsoft Office 365 SharePoint sales team site. If I go to site content, I can see there are a few libraries already here. I want to create a new document library which is called invoices, where I can upload all the invoices from the client. I can go here, click on new and click on document library, and it will create a document library for me. So what if there's a requirement to create a new document library as part of the Power Automate workflow process? So to achieve that, if I go back to Office 365 and I will click on Power Automate application icon, this will open up the Power Automate Studio for me so I can create flows here. From the left hand menu, I will click on create, and for the purpose of this demo, I will just create an instant cloud flow. So I will click on that. Okay, so I will give this flow a name. I will just call it create library, and I will manually trigger this flow and click on create. To create a SharePoint library, there is no out of the box action available in Power Automate flow to create a library. So we have to use HTTP request to create this library. So if I click on new step, so if I search for send HTTP, I can see there is an action of SharePoint which is send an HTTP request to SharePoint. So I will select that. First thing first, I need to select a SharePoint site where I need to create that document library. So you can either select from a drop down or you can put a custom value. So my site is already listed here. So I will select sales team. So the method, we are not getting the information, we are posting it. So we are creating a library, so we'll put this as a post method. And the URI, as you can see in the example, is also give you a hint that underscore API web list. So because we are creating a document library, we need to provide this URL until list. So API /web/list and then /. Okay, now in the header, I need to provide a content type, content-type colon, and then the value is going to be application /json semicolon or data is equal to verbose. So that's the header value we need to provide. So in the body, we will put the actual JSON body, what we're going to request. So I will just put curly brackets, open and close curly brackets. And then first thing we need to provide the template, the base template for the library. So the base template for SharePoint list is 100, where the base template for a document library is 101. So I will just create a double quotation and type base template colon space 101 and then comma. So the next thing we need to provide is the description of the library. So again, in double quote, just type description and then colon space. And then again in double quotes, I'm putting a text value in here. So I'm saying this is a library to store invoices, so comma again. Now, one final thing we need to provide here is the title of the library. So again in the quotation mark, title, colon, space, and then quotation mark again, and then the name of the library. So I'll just call it invoices. So that's it really. So let's do a recap. We provided a site address and the method is going to be the post. And the URI, we're going to put it until list. And then the header is going to be content type, application JSON, or data verbose. And then in the body, we are providing the base template, the description, and the title, which is invoices. So base template 101 will ensure that it creates a document library. If it's a list, you can create it 100. So that's the base template for list. Okay, so once I complete that, I will click on save. Now the workflow is saved. So if I go back to that sales side, there is no invoices library exist on the side at the moment. So let's go ahead and test our workflow. So I will click on test. I will click on manually. I will click on save and test. Now it is signing me into the SharePoint side. So if I have permission, I will be able to create a document library. So I will click on sign in. And then now I will click on run flow. Okay, then I will click on done. Now you can see the flow has run successfully. It have posted that HTTP request to the SharePoint site. Now if I go back to the SharePoint sales team site and if I just refresh this page, now you can see there is a new library called invoices which just got created. So if I go to setting of this library and click on library name, description and navigation, I can see there's a description which we put into the library while provisioning via Power Automate also displayed here. So I'll just cancel that. So the new document library is ready. Now you can go ahead and upload documents, invoices here manually, or you can do it as part of the workflow process. So to just recap this video, in this video you have learned how to provision a new document library in SharePoint site using Power Automate workflow and using the SharePoint send HTTP request action. Thank you very much for watching this video. Consider subscribing if you're new to the channel by pressing the red subscribe button below this video and click the notification bell icon so you don't miss any of my future videos as I upload new videos every week. Give this video a thumbs up if you found it useful. If you have any question regarding this topic or any other query related to Office 365, put in the comment section below. I review the comment on a daily basis. I will be happy to answer your questions. Thank you.